Hi, in today's video I'm going to be making a tiny pizza for my hamster Mabel. I'm going to start by making the tomato sauce for the base. Just be aware that tomatoes are highly acidic, so it's best if you only feed a very small amount to your hamster occasionally, so less than half a teaspoon every month really. I'm boiling the tomato for about 5 minutes to soften it up and then chucking it in the blender. Once the tomato has been blended up, I'm going to reduce it in a pan for about 5 minutes or so, and this is just going to get rid of the excess water within the tomato so it's a bit thicker and more sauce-like. Next I'm using half a teaspoon of flour and a quarter teaspoon of water to make the pizza dough. I was a little bit worried that by only using these ingredients that even after baking it might look a little bit anemic, but honestly it worked out fine and it did develop a tiny bit of colour in the oven too. Then when I'm happy with the texture of the dough after mixing, I'm just going to roll it out till it's about 2 mm thick. I'm just using this little plate as a guide for the shape of the pizza, and I'm leaving room around it because next I'll be pinching the sides up over themselves to form a puffy pizza crust. Now I'm happy with the shape of my pizza, I'm going to go ahead and fill it with tomato sauce. As you can see, I've only had to use a tiny amount of what I actually made, so I'm not really that worried about the overall acidity of the pizza. Now I've got the base of the pizza spread on, I'm going to grate some cheese and sprinkle that on top. Hamsters can eat cheese because they have a special pouch in their digestive systems that help them to break down lactose, but unfortunately I don't have that. So this cheese I'm using is mature cheddar and it's lactose free. But spoiler, Mabel didn't actually end up liking this, and I think it might have been too strong a flavour for her. So if I did this again, or if you want to make a pizza for your hamster, I'd definitely recommend using a mild cheddar instead, and maybe just letting them taste it beforehand to see if they do like it. For the toppings, I'm breaking up some freeze-dried chicken to put on top. This was really easy because the texture of freeze-dried chicken is so different to regular cooked chicken. It just kind of like crumbles in your hand. Then to add a little bit of veg, I'm just chopping up some spinach and sprinkling that on top. To cook the pizza, I'm turning on my fan oven to about 180 degrees centigrade, and then I'm going to let it bake for about 10 minutes. I'm so happy with how it turns out, which is why Mabel obviously chose not to like it. Thank you so much for watching. Please like, comment, and subscribe for more.